This week on Rugged Expeditions, we're doing something a little bit different. Instead of hunting, we're gonna try and catch a live cattle-killing jaguar and hopefully move him further away from civilization where he won't get in so much trouble. Getting out to Faramora Ranch is an adventure in itself. You fly into Ascension, and then Rocky picks you up in his plane.
Hi, Alan. How are you, Dan? Hey,
good to see you again. Nice to see you. Welcome to Paraguay.
Can't wait.
Flies you a couple hours north into the dry Chaco jungle. Luckily, there's a nice dirt strip right by his house where we all stay while we're up here hunting. Gorgeous area, vast land tracts up here. Most of the ranches up here are hundreds of thousands of acres. It's great to be back in Paraguay with Rocky McBride. I've hunted buffalo with him in the past. Go for my shot. And it's always been a fantastic adventure.
What a great animal. Buffalo hunting in the swamps of Paraguay.
I've also been here to catch jaguars for scientific purposes with them a few years ago, and it's just as exciting, if not more so, than actually hunting. Jaguars are big, mean cats, able to kill buffalo-sized animals, and they don't like to be pursued, and they sure don't like having a dart stuck in their hind end. The problem with the jaguars is that although they're fairly adaptable and can handle some disturbance to their environment, when cattle are brought onto the farms, it creates a new, easy food source for the jaguars. As part of the jaguar relocation project here in Paraguay, they've built these pens with a lot of natural habitat in it. And after the jaguar's been captured, they're brought here. They let them settle down for a little while. That gives them the chance to, you know, get the drugs out of their system, get a little more acclimated before they move them somewhere else. That's called a soft release. Rather than just catching them out there, getting them drugged up and moving them a long distance to get them away from the cattle, this system's worked really well and it's been a 100% success rate once they've moved them from these facilities out. It's a pretty good project. There's no jaguar getting out of here. Our plan was to try and find one of the cats that had been killing cattle on a nearby ranch. Rocky had a pretty good idea where the marauder was hanging out. We just had to get over into the area where they were at so we could turn the dogs out and hopefully they'd catch the scent and tree it. Rocky's hounds are a mixture of American breeds he's brought in and mixed with local hunting dogs. They're a tough animal who live with extreme danger every time they get out of the truck. Veterinarian Dr. Sybil Zavala has worked with Rocky since 2007 and is an expert on jaguars. Sybil's a big part of the team. She handles the hounds, sometimes having to stitch them up from the wounds from fighting with the jaguars. Rocky works closely with the locals, and when a problem cat is identified, he'll bring his pack of trained hounds in and catch the cat, put a research collar on it, and move it to a new location away from cattle and release it. As simple as that sounds, it's not.
Obviously something dead with that many buzzards. Let's go see what they got. It's a small tapir, it's not a big one. But there's no cuts on him. It's not like a jaguar got him or nothing. Maybe he just died of old age. Just wore out. He's not going to get any older, that's for sure.
Rugged Expedition. Rugged Expedition. Paraguay jungle is home to many diverse species. And with that comes the battle for survival. Jaguars are killing the local farmers' cattle, and in return, farmers are threatening the jaguars' existence. This conflict has been brought to the attention of Rocky McBride, who along with J. Allen Smith hope to resolve this nuisance in a safe, non-lethal manner.
We've got our hands full on this trip. Not only are we trying to capture a cattle killer and put a collar on it, we've also got another cat that's already got a collar on it, but the battery's about to go dead, and we've got to catch it before it does. Rocky had a pretty good idea where this jaguar might be hanging out, but jaguars, even the females, cover a huge area.
The jaguar is the largest cat of South America. Having once roamed the southern tip of the continent to the northern region surrounding the U.S. and Mexico border. These beautiful beasts were prominent in ancient Native American religions. In some cultures, the jaguar is the god of the night and was the formidable lord of the underworld. During the 60s and 70s, jaguars were hunted for their prized fur, and farmers would kill them because they're destructive to their cattle. The jaguar has since become endangered, and in an effort to protect these cats, the Federal Endangered Species Act prohibits the importation and sale of their furs in the United States. In spite of laws being in place, the number of jaguars has declined due to the destruction of the animal's habitat and farmers taking action to protect their livestock. But with Rocky McBride's undertaking to preserve their livelihood, research and transplanting has steadily improved their population. Hunter conservationist J. Allen Smith, in conjunction with Safari Club International Foundation, has made the long trek to the Chaco jungle of Paraguay to help capture some of these elusive predators.
Weather's a constant issue in the jungle, as you all well know. You never know what's gonna happen. One day there's not a cloud in the sky. One morning there's not a cloud in the sky. Then all of a sudden you're driving home at the end of the day thinking, is that rain clouds coming this way? The rainy season decided to come early this year, which really made it tough getting around. It's messing up all our well-intentioned plans.
That's right, there you go.
I've been in a lot of rainstorms in a lot of places. Some of you might remember the time when I was in Liberia and I got stuck for more than 24 hours in one hole in a big old mud bog.
Give us your statistical odds, Dave, of what you think is going to happen here, success or not success.
Well, I'm going to keep it kosher, you know, as far as my vocabulary goes, but I'll give us a whopping 5% chance of not getting stuck.
And how long have we been stuck here at this mud hole?
It's now 10:30. That makes it 12 hours. Yeah.
Right on the money.
Yep.
Awesome.
And that was the only thing that was running through my mind as we were trying to get back in the dark, trying to get back to Rocky's lodge.
Did I ever tell you, Rocky, you're my hero?
No.
I wish we could get home.
Here right now singing.
Where did we get home?
We were just stuck just a minute ago, and Rocky has gotten us going again.
I'm not so sure this is a good idea. It's not easing off at all. Next time when Rocky says, I think it's gonna rain and we should get going, that's when we should actually listen to him and do what he says. Rocky just kept the pedal to the metal, four-wheel drive, and sooner or later, woohoo, we made it. All the rain and flooding made Rocky's somewhat tame ocelot named Ray decide to come and pay us a visit one night.
He was found as a little kitten, and he's still wild. He goes out and hunts on his own, and
But he comes in every night and he hangs out here in the lodge. And the good thing is down here in Paraguay, while we're working on the jaguars, also these kinds of animals, the ocelots and the jaguarundi and all that, are also benefiting from it, because as you're protecting the habitat for the jaguars, all these other lesser cats are also receiving the same benefits. So it's a neat deal that we get to, you know, protect a lot of different species while we're working on the Jaguar project. I find it incredible just how hard it can rain in South America.
Now that the skies have cleared, Alain and the team can get back to work.
With the dogs not being able to pick up any kind of a scent on the cattle killing jaguar due to all the rain, we decided to deal with problem number two, which was we have a female cat that's been out there for almost a year now with a radio collar on her, but that battery is about to die.
These are the ones we actually want to relocate. Because of this big rain, we can't, it's just not logistically possible to relocate them. And the pen that I've got there at the ranch is completely underwater now, so. But we do have to put new collars on these cats or we're gonna lose them. And so what we're gonna do is try to collar them and then come back in July and when it dries down enough and relocate them.
If Rocky and Sybil can't get to this cat before this battery goes dead, now all the scientific research that's been happening on this cat stops. Now what we're gonna have to do was drive out a lot further away from where we had been trying to catch cats and see if we could pick up the signal on one of the radio antennas. Trying to find the signal from this cat is a tedious process. You drive, you stop, you get up, you hold the antenna, you try and locate it, there's no signal, you move on. When that didn't work, we were only left with one option, and that was to try and get the airplane up in the air and see if we could pick up the cat's signal from the airplane. These are the collars that end up going on to the jaguars. They're good for a year, sometimes more. Sends a signal up to the satellite. You keep track of them, see where they're going and what their habits are, especially after they've been relocated. Because if you've moved them to a different area, you want to make sure that both they've adapted to it and also that they don't end up going right back to where you just moved them from and going back to their cattle killing ways, if that's the problem. Luckily, after quite a while of flying around, we finally heard the signal. When we got the strong signal, Rocky checked his logbook and we discovered that sure as hell, it was the right cat. It was the one that the collar was about to go dead on.
After gaining a signal, the team will now need to track the cat on the ground before it moves further away.
Got a radio collar jaguar back in here, and we're within 2 kilometers of it according to the radio signal and the GPS that we saw flying over it this morning. So we're gonna go down this old power line and hopefully get close enough that we can turn those dogs loose once we get the radio on it. Because we did have a bit of an idea where he was gonna be at because of the geography and the maps that we had, we decided to just get out and start walking and take the antenna with us, and hopefully we'd be able to walk into an area where we'd be able to use the antenna, pick up the signal, even if it was faint, and then go in from there.
J. Jay Allen Smith has traveled to Paraguay to help Rocky McBride in his endeavor to protect jaguars. The team is searching for a particular cat whose radio collar is about to die. If the crew can't find the feline and replace the battery fast, the research will end and the cattle-killing threat may return. Local farmers have been retaliating because their cattle is being slaughtered by these huge cats. So the team hopes to transplant the problem somewhere less endangering to both.
There we go. Finally. Okay, now it's the running and chasing apart.
The dogs have struck the trail. They're heading off this way now.
Yeah, we gave the cat a big head start.
The good news is they've got his scent. The bad news is it's probably been laying in here resting, waiting for us. Set that thing aside. Dark Paraguay jaguars. Doesn't get any more rugged than this. Caleb's going to push it out of the tree. Make sure she's in good shape. Still doing good. Rocky's gonna take this old collar off now that is just about to have the battery go dead, and we're gonna put a fresh one on it now so they can continue to study it. Plus, when they come back to relocate it, they'll have a fresh collar on it so it doesn't go dead. This collar's been on almost a year now.
Congratulations, Alain.
Thank you, Rocky. Man, thanks for all you're doing for these jaguars. This is incredible to be out here and to get to do this and study them and put these collars on them and save them and, you know, move them to different places and all these things you're doing. I mean, I know it's got to be a love to do it because this is tough, tough work, as the audience can well see by the looks of the two of us. Thanks, Sybil, for all you're doing, too.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Man, what a nice job you're doing on these things. You know, it's partnerships like this with Rocky McBride and Safari Club International Foundation that really pay off when it comes to doing these studies on great species like the jaguar here of South America. Putting new collars on them, moving the problem animals away from the cattle farmers, these are the things that have to be done for science-based conservation. Thanks to both those folks, Safari Club International Foundation, First for Wildlife.